In this video, we will continue working on the fox design. This time, we will trace the image we used in the previous video and create a new design with that same fox. Let's start by importing the image. This time, from the image handling options, we will select Auto-Digitize, Convert to Outlines. The trace dialog appears to assist us with the conversion process. In reality, the trace dialog tries to create a vector design based on the imported image. If you prefer, you can customize a few options. First of all, you can scale the imported image. For example, if you want the design to fit into a 140 by 140 hoop, you need to scale up a little. The accuracy option allows you to choose how much detail of the original artwork will be in your final embroidery design. According to the quality of the image, you may need to increase, see 8 is maximum, or decrease. Images are made of dots, so for high-quality images, you can increase the accuracy. For low-quality pictures, though, using high accuracy may actually lead to a bad trace design. If you enable Show Notes and zoom on the artwork, you will see that for this image, high accuracy produces too many nodes. Instead, if you choose accuracy 5, the artwork is very clean. Now, using the color limit, you can select the number of colors that you want to use. Using the background option, you can select a color from the image, and that color will be removed from the traced ones. Now, press Trace to perform the actual conversion, and the design is ready. Remember that it's always a good practice to review the artwork of the design with Node Editor and fix any areas that may need refining. As you can see, there are some spots that have these zigzags of nodes. Just deleting those nodes shall make the artwork cleaner. Using the backdrop options from the View menu, you can change the view of the image. Now that the artwork is ready, you can apply any stitch type you choose. The overall body of the fox ends up in a bizarre shape, but using the stitch flow, we can add directions or virtually divide the shape to improve the flow of the stitches. We can also change the properties of the fill or the outline. For example, we can apply a pattern or change the density. As already mentioned, you can edit and fine-tune the shape you have created at any point. For the end of the tail, let's select another stitch type and let's also change the direction of the stitches. Editing the stitches further will give this fox tail a far more realistic effect. Well, this is my take of this design. The software allows you to create a whole range of different looks based on your individual inspiration and a bit of artistic experimenting with the software tools. Enjoy creating!